Did you know that stress and blood sugar levels are connected? I am not messing with you right now. It's actually the real deal. Yes, we all know that certain foods like carbs can send your blood glucose levels through the roof, right? But how can stress be connected with that? Well, I need you to watch further because not only am I going to explain how it works, I'm also going to give you 5 simple techniques to relax and to help keep your blood sugar levels at normal levels. Okay, so when you have type 1 or type 2 diabetes, stress has a huge role to play. When you experience physical or emotional stress, your body releases stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline. Now, in response, the body releases an extra energy into the bloodstream in the form of glucose, and now this is a perfectly natural body reaction. Now, for example, if you're being chased by a vicious animal or you're in some other dangerous situation, you need these hormones to prepare your body for a fight or flight mode. But when you're stressed, your body releases these hormones even if there isn't a major physical threat involved. And the result of it? Well, higher blood pressure, increased heart rate, and a rise in blood sugar. Now, when you have diabetes, it can become a big problem because when the stress is constant, your hormones and blood sugar will continue to surge. Now, also keep in mind that your blood sugar levels due to stress depend on which type of diabetes that you have. So if you have type 2, you generally experience an increase in blood glucose levels. But if you have type 1 diabetes, you may have a more varied response. You can experience either an increase or a decrease in blood glucose levels. So what you have to do whenever you feel stressed is to monitor your blood sugar levels. This way, you'll see if stress is actually affecting them or not. Now, what I strongly recommend you do is when you feel stressed, to rate your level of mental stress on a scale of 1 to 10. 10 reflects the highest level of stress. Write this number down in your journal. Now, after rating your stress, check your glucose levels. Continue doing this for the next couple of weeks. After some time, you'll notice the pattern. If you see that your glucose is regularly high, it is likely that stress is negatively affecting your blood sugar. Now, I know that everyday life can be stressful, okay? Pressure at work, problems in the family or in relationships, trying to cope with everyday tasks and responsibilities. And guys, no need to say that controlling diabetes itself can be emotionally draining, especially in those early days when you've just been diagnosed. You have to pay close attention to what you eat and you need lots of new things to learn and to remember. It can be tough, okay? In fact, people with diabetes are 20% more likely to experience anxiety than those without the condition. Finding the right ways to deal with stress when you have diabetes is an absolute must. Okay, so that's why I put together 5 simple yet very effective techniques that will help you relax and keep normal blood sugar levels. Number 1 is exercising. Even brief periods of walking can help you relax and deal better with stress. Now, if you can exercise in a gym or join some kind of exercise class, you are away from whatever is troubling you and you can just focus in on that particular activity, which is good. And hey guys, exercising doesn't have to be complicated. Try to get at least 150 minutes per week of moderate intensity physical activity. You can try to fit in at least 20 or 25 minutes of activity every day, even if it's swimming, brisk walking, or even riding your bike. Now, in fact, one study shows that any form of regular movement, regardless of exercise limitations, reduces feelings of stress, and that is good. Number 2, start meditation. Any kind of meditation can help get rid of negative thoughts and allow your mind to just relax. Now, whether this is spiritual meditation, cognitive therapy, or yoga, it all makes a huge difference. Mindfulness techniques are designed to help you reduce stress. So try to start each morning with a 15-minute meditation. Find a quiet space to focus on your breathing, push away all those negative thoughts from your head, and let yourself be present in that moment. I can guarantee that this will set your tone for the rest of the day. Number 3, start writing a journal. Keeping a gratitude journal or writing down your thoughts, the positive ones, in a diary is a great stress buster. If you write down all that you're grateful for every day or any other positive things that happen to you, you will calm your brain down and you will release some positivity. This will decrease stress and it will help you see your situation from a different perspective. Number 4, try out the Klinio app. Klinio changes the way you approach diabetes, your everyday routine, and your food. Now, lots of people who have been using this app agree that it helps you take small steps towards sustainable results, avoiding anxiety and diabetes burnout. So check the app in the description I put down below this video and keep your diabetes-related stress far away. All right, number 5, find a hobby. You know how they say find something you love to do and you'll never work another day in your life? well, you can adopt that same philosophy to your hobby. Explore new activities that keep you moving and that distract you at the same time. And there are plenty of options for you here. Okay, try hiking in new settings every weekend, traveling to another city, and maybe just spending the whole day walking around. Also, maybe you're up to volunteering in your local community's organization, or hey, simply starting up a backyard garden. Give yourself some time to really find what you like. And at the end of the day, it is all about taking care of yourself and keeping that stress away. I can't stress that enough. All right, now go check out these other videos on the Klinio channel, and I will see you next time.